Hi everyone. Good morning. It is August 8th. It is 9 o'clock in the morning here in Toronto, Canada. This is my cat Molly, who has not left me alone since 7 a.m. Meowing at me, rubbing on me, trying to get my attention. She has now been fed and watered, and she still won't leave me alone. So her meowing has been getting to me. I am hoping now that she will, because I actually picked her up. She doesn't like that too much. She tolerates it. She doesn't like it. Now she's furiously grooming herself, so maybe that will, you know, abate the meows so I can get this video done. Because I've been desperate to do another video. It's been almost 2 weeks since I got my laptop back. And, I haven't done another video. And partly the reason why is I haven't been stitching. And I hate it. I hate that I haven't been stitching. There's good reasons why I haven't been stitching. Because I started school again. Which is a whole other thing, which is going to come up later. But I haven't had the energy to stitch at all, but I haven't wanted to stitch because I had, if you'll remember, you'll see there's someone new in the lap stand. I had Storytime Sampler on there, and I had gotten almost all of the, I was working on August's frame because it was just August. We'd gotten Phantom of the Opera, which I was stoked. Katie, you are not the only one who loves Phantom. I fangirl about Phantom. I first saw Phantom when I was 11 years old. My dad was a huge musical fan, and I love him for that because of the fact that he gave me this love that I have for musicals and all kind of musical theater. And Phantom of the Opera, he had the tapes. Oh my god, this was back in the early 90s. He has a set of three tapes for the entire Phantom of the Opera musical. And because we only had a tape deck in our car, so we would listen to it on our very long road trips that we would take every summer. So my dad would put in the first tape and he would play the entire thing through. And so we would get used to the music. And I would pick up on the story behind the music. And my brother, my sister, not so much, but I really did. And I would ask my dad about it, and he would usually, because I was a big reader, I started reading when I was like 3, like really comprehensively. I've always been a big reader. Where was I going with that tangent? Yes, that's the great thing with webcams. I just stopped recording, went back, and saw where I was at. Okay, so what I was saying was I would be in these really long road trips. I grew up in Labrador. I don't know if any of you know where Labrador is. It's part of Newfoundland and Labrador, which is the easternmost province of Canada. Newfoundland is an island. Labrador is the mainland part attached to the northern part of Quebec. So I grew up in northern Canada. Brochet, hi, I love your video that you just put out. I love your haul, everything in your haul. It was so awesome. I grew up where the Northern Lights were a very regular thing. And they are spectacular, and I think everyone should see them before, you know. Anyway, so. So, road trips. We would travel from Labrador to Quebec City area every year, because that's where my mom was from. And my parents were both educators and had the summers off. So we would always leave town for the summers. And because it was so remote, it was very extremely expensive to travel out of there. For the first few years, because there wasn't actually a road, we would put our car on a train and then take the train down to a smaller place in Quebec and then get our car and drive the rest of the way. But after, I think, I'd have to look this up, but I'm not sure when, but I believe sometime in the late 80s or early 90s, they finished the road, which is part of the Trans-Canada Highway. And it is about, it took us, I think, 1,400 kilometers, I believe, is the distance that we would travel. My dad would always set the trip guide to see how long it would be. And I believe it was always about, not 1,400, it could have been 1,400. Yeah, 1,400. It took us about 15 hours to get there, and we would drive it in one day. We had an old 80-something, I think it was like an 86, 87 Aerostar van that we drove around in. And we would pack it up to the gills, like we would put ourselves in there and pack things around us. And we would drive down in a day. And so we would listen to these musicals. Phantom of the Opera was the first one. And I would get the little insert, the little fold-out insert that would have lyrics on it, really tiny lyrics, from the cassette case, and I would read the lyrics to better understand the story. And I loved that. I thought it was fantastic. So he did that with several musicals, and we saw several in Toronto, because we would do Quebec for about a month, and then we would always do Toronto for about a month, because some more relatives that my mother lived in Toronto, or Mississauga outside of Toronto. But we would always come into the city and see a show from, I think, the summer that I was 11 on. And Phantom of the Opera was first at the Pantages Theatre in Toronto. Les Misérables was second, which is one of my absolute favorites. And I think Miss Saigon was third. And I'm really testing, because I think after that I didn't really like any of the things. And then there was Rent. But there was also several musicals that I never got to see that I really love the music for. Sunset Boulevard is one. Aspects of Love is a very little known Andrew Lloyd Webber. It didn't succeed very well. It had really bad reviews, but the music is fantastic in it. I love it. I listen to it all the time. My dad had the CDs. Apparently it had a small revival in the early part of the millennium, but it never came to North America. It had a small revival in England. It was a really good, the music of it is really good. Secret Garden I never saw, which I wanted to. Rent I managed to see eventually twice, I think, twice or three times. Avenue Q I haven't seen yet, but I haven't really listened to a lot of music. Sweeney Todd I haven't seen, and I really want to see Sweeney Todd, because I kind of like the more macabre, dark musicals, which will key into something that I'm doing later that I will announce later. How did I feel about this month's Storytime Sampler? Well, there you go. I was really stoked. I think it is my favorite frame. And I'm going to do a few adjustments, I think, to some color. And I think to I'm going to make the chandelier metallic gold. I think I'm going to go with the gold I have, because it's a pretty dark gold. It's a Krennic. Hold on, let me see. I'm easily amused. It's my daughter's birthday. Happy birthday, Amelia! She's not here. She's with my parents in Quebec at our family home, which is the same one that we would go to every summer. And she loves it there. She goes to a day camp with a bunch of people that she's been going to day camp with for many years. So She really enjoys it. So I messaged her this morning, and I was talking back and forth with her. And I told her that she gets to pick out a new DS game for her birthday from us. So she's really excited about that. Anyway, so happy birthday. She's never going to see this. She can't. She cannot know about this blog. It's just, it's not a good thing. Anyway, no one tell her. maybe when she's 16 or 17. Okay, I can't want her to mimic me in doing a video blog. I can't. She's too young for that. I don't agree with putting, you know, she has an account on Facebook, but it's not her own name. She makes up names. She changes her name on Facebook like every week or so. She's really into anime and everything Japanese, so she keeps making up Japanese sounding names. And they might be saying the most, you know, rude thing. Ooh, that's pretty. No, I have a Chromecast, and when it's not in use and the TV is on, it just cycles through a bunch of art. And there's this really cool one on there right now. It's called Flight Pattern by Rob Evans. The name's on the thing. And it's like this painting of this really ornate clock, and there's a Luna moth on the wall next to it. It's very dark. And then out the window is this like a view of like a city like in the distance, and there's a track where a plane just went by through the sky, and it's all really, really dark. It's very, very, very cool. I haven't seen that one yet. They add new ones all the time. It's really cool. If you don't have a Chromecast and you're a Chrome Google user, yeah, they're so worth the investment, especially now since they're actually starting to bring things out for it. Anyway, so back to the Phantom of the Opera. I think I'm going to use this gold, which is it's a bright gold, but it's not a light gold. So, for the chandelier. If not, I might go darker gold. Unfortunately, I'm probably not going to get to my LNS for a while, because of things, mainly finances, and things are changing. Things just are. I am going to warn you now. I probably should have earlier. I made a list, and I didn't even look at my list when I started. I should have. So the first thing on my list I was going to say was that notebooks. Yes. I think it was Michaela who recommended Evernote. Evernote came with my tablet, and I haven't really been using it. When she said that you could easily cross-platform it, I was kind of like, yeah, I want to check that out. So I've been working on it a little bit. Not too much, but where are all my notebooks now? No! Did I remove them? Oh. There we go. Okay. Way behind. There we go. Okay. Sorry, because I just synced up my notebooks from my Android to my computer to my laptop, and I was having a problem with it. But I thought I had ended up transferring them instead of syncing them up, but I haven't. It's here. Okay. So, first note, yes, the first part of this is mainly going to be diary and talking about what's going on right now, non-stitchy stuff, why I'm not stitching, how I feel about not stitching, what I'm doing to try to get back to stitching. So if you are not that interested, it might be a little rambly, it might be a little long, you can skip ahead. I will make sure to note right here and put down right here when the actual stitchy stuff picks back up. Okay, so if you want to skip, I have no problem with that. It's mainly just a personal record for myself. I'm trying to get a few things worked through, and I find talking to myself helps. So if you don't want to deal with that, skip ahead. If not, hi, welcome to my insanity. no, not exactly. So, yes. So, I want to use the gold for the chandelier. But other than that, I might try to get like a variegated thread for the curtains, the red. Something that just gives it more like a fabric kind of look. I don't think I'm actually going to make any alterations to this one. I'm really torn on the Lady Shalott because it was July and it was my birthday month and it's something I'm not familiar with. And I really wished it was... Anyway. So I don't know if I'm going to make any alterations to her at all either. I might just stitch her as is because I don't know enough. I've seen some people putting gold in their crown, and I'm trying to put some metallic in every single one, just to give it a little overall sparkle. I've tried to alter Sherlock now because in the Frost Pumpkin Facebook group, someone created the exact pattern of wallpaper that's in the living room on the show Sherlock with Benedict Cumberbatch and Martin Freeman. And on my previous attempt at Sherlock, I put a bookcase there. But if you put a bookcase there, there's no room to show there's nowhere to show the wallpaper pattern. It's either bookcase or wallpaper pattern. So I was thinking of getting rid of the teapot and putting some books there, like a stack of books. But that didn't really look good. It just looked like lines on the table, and I guess some back stitching would have been needed. Anyway, so I haven't actually done any of this in stitching yet. I've just basically done some sketching on my my Android, my tablet. This is just a little bit. Okay, there we go. It's like you're seeing so much wall and, oh, my dragon necklace. I keep meaning to put this on, but it's my little talisman, I guess. It's just a good feeling when I wear it. Unfortunately, I kind of want to get a, unfortunately, the thing is not very big. I kind of want to, like, get a cord or something braided for this because of the fact that this is a very, very, very cheap necklace. It was bought by my daughter very nicely at probably Hot Topic or something. And because Hot Topic is her favorite store. And I love the pendant. Don't really like the chain. So I'm thinking about doing something either braided or working it into a hemp necklace, because I can make those too. So, so I don't know if I'm going to make any change. Anyway, if I don't do the books on Sherlock, I'm going to do his tea set in silver. So it's like a silver tea set. And hoping that we'll bring the sparkle there. If I do the books, I'm going to do the candlesticks on the mantle, silver or gold, I'm not sure which. So yeah, those are my plans, but as you can see, story time's not there. Who's there? Sailor Moon is there. I needed something different. I kept beating myself up that I haven't just picked up and stitched on Storytime Sampler, because it's not that it's an easy stitch. It is an easy stitch. The patterns are simple, big blocks of color. I like that. But the amount of color changes, and I couldn't just stitch on something for more than 5 minutes without having to change the thread, is driving me insane. So what I'm going to do is end up probably putting away just for a little bit, at least through the end of next week, and trying to work on her. I shouldn't be talking about Suju stuff, because the people who I kicked out are not going to remember this. I'm going to have to repeat this for them. I'll do that. Okay. So, yes. Okay. Completely off the Suju topic. I started school 2 weeks ago. You know, I've been talking about it in my previous videos. And I was doing an accounting and payroll course. The thing I had previously done in my life was I worked as a loan administrator for a financial trust company, which basically means lending money for investments. Everything I've learned from living or from working in that industry for over, 8 years. Don't borrow money to invest. That's it. Don't do it. Basically, I was data entry. I was a loan administrator. I was basically taking care of the main daily, day-to-day processes that every loan account goes through. Oh, I need my address changed. Oh, I need my phone number changed. I need my banking information changed. I need a copy of this letter. I need a copy of that letter. I need to know if I have any, you know, day-to-day administration. I liked what I did because of the people around me. And because I could have, you know, things at my desk which would make me happy. And for me, as a big geek, my stuff is my expression of myself. I'm not a very extroverted person. So if I put little hints around me of what I like, I find I attract like-minded people and we start talking. It's my little introverted trick. And it worked very well for many years. Then the recession hit. I did not lose my job, thankfully. And I kept my head down. I actually moved laterally within the company because I was not able to move up in the department I started in. Previous to this, I had gone to school to become a paralegal and finished my course with honors. Unfortunately, I had no experience beforehand. I had just come back from the States after having my daughter. My daughter was 2. I was living off of my parents. My parents told me, we'll send you to school and we'll pay for your, you know, your housing and all that and anything you need. And yes, so it was tough. But because I'm bilingual, French and English, I was able to get this data entry job at this company. It was a document management center, which interestingly is DMC, and it was the abbreviation for our department was DMC. I just thought about that. That was kind of funny. Basically, we were a mailroom. We were a mailroom, but we also had OCR technology, and we did scanning because all of the business was done through the computer and scanned documents. So because of that, I was there for 3 years and then moved laterally into a team because I then had a little more experience, a team that had advancement opportunities. And then I just kind of got, then the recession really, you know, hit and we were doing really bad business. We weren't doing bad business. There was no bad business practices. We just weren't doing as much business as we had been in previous years. And the company was sold to one of our biggest rivals. And those biggest rivals had very different ideas of how corporate structure should work. They employed a principle of clean desk, principle, basically. If everyone's desk tops were always clean, there was nothing unneeded on any of their cubicle walls, you know, it was a sterile environment. Apparently, they were told this works better. It didn't work better for me. I developed many physical ailments brought on by stress, including migraines, severe IBS, and I mean migraines that lasted a week, that I would get relief from very briefly using an extremely expensive medication that you were only supposed to use once or twice, you know, before it's not going to work. And I would use many and it would finally work. But they were very expensive. Anyway, my doctor finally put me on leave because my health was deteriorating. I was missing too much work. And I was getting doctor notes every single time I was getting off work. Because it was that point. So my doctor finally put me on leave. And my ailments got worse. Because I was trying to get better and there was no one to help me. I kind of sunk into a depression because I felt like I had failed. I was put on many, many, many different kinds of medications, antipsychotics, anxieties. And the lovely cocktail I had managed to be put on caused me no amounts of extra pain. The depression with a certain mixture of drugs caused a very, very, very rapid waking. And my body wasn't able to properly adjust to the weight coming on, which has caused me it's such a bullshit diagnosis, but it's the only one they have for it. And it sounds like a bullshit diagnosis, but it is a real thing. It's unspecified pain disorder. And I know many of others of you on Flosstube are have various ranges of disabilities. And I commiserate with you guys so much every time you mention it. And sorry about that. I accidentally hit the laptop and stopped recording. Enough of my pity and strife. Things, though, are getting very slowly better. It took me about the same amount of time as it took me to wean on to the... And that was the problem, too. My freaking doctor kept upping my dose when I kept telling him it's not working. And it... this is the reason I'm getting a new doctor. I am now completely off any kind of medication. I felt I had been on antidepressants for several years. And I think I plateaued. And I had been told by several pharmacists who kept seeing the amount of medication that my doctor was giving me and telling me, this isn't good. This is not for long-term use. These are for, you know, getting you over the humps and trying to find the proper coping techniques to stop this. I had, because I was on disability, I had really good insurance through the company I'd work with, and was up for, they wanted to get me back to work, obviously. So I did therapy sessions through them. Unfortunately, they only offered 3 months of therapy, and it was only to get back to work. It was not dealing with underlying issues. It was not dealing with familial issues. It was not dealing with, you know, my issues with my boyfriend. It wasn't dealing with any of that. It was strictly, how do I get you back to work? And I had basically near the end of it, I couldn't do it anymore. I couldn't, I couldn't go back. I wasn't ready. I had found a few different places who do free therapy, but there's long waiting lists. And also the process of getting into them is a lot of phone calls, and I have developed an aversion to talking to anyone over the phone. It's kind of a really big step I'm trying to get over, and I slowly am, the more confident I'm getting. I'm managing my pain now, which is great, and it's helped me a lot in the last week. Unfortunately, that's all I'm gonna say about that. I have lifted the ban on Dr. Pepper this weekend because of certain mitigating factors. I would need the caffeine, and this is the most effective way to get my caffeine, because I have things to do, and I need to be clear-headed to do so. So, where was I now? Freaking cow thought. Wandered onto the tracks again. Where did it go? Anyway, so pain is managed. I am doing a lot more exercise. In the last week, last 2 weeks of going to school every day, I have done more exercise than probably in the previous 2 months. If that will tell you anything. And my energy levels are just going up. Yes, I feel tired and achy, and the pain is a little bit worse when I'm unmedicated, and but I know why. It's because I'm pushing myself and I'm burning calories, hopefully, and because, to be completely honest, we're pretty sure the only treatment for this pain to make it go away is to drop the weight, which is really hard, as I'm sure many of you know. I'm not counting calories at the moment. I can't. Wow, I need to stop making excuses, and I've been really beating myself up every time I start making excuses. My mind is not organized as other people's do. You know, people say, make a to-do list. I'll make a to-do list all day long. I will make to-do lists. I can have it formatted 8 different ways, color-coded, collated between, you know, which priority these activities should be in. I will make those lists every day. I won't follow them. I will never go back and look at them. So, you saw that. I made a list today. I made a to-do list for this video, and I did not go back and look at it. So, I'm trying to figure out other ways to remind myself of doing things and other ways of scheduling things. I have a calendar, a really cool calendar app on my tablet. It is super cool. I love it. So that's my calendar. Let's see if you can see it. You see those stickers? I love those stickers. I love those stickers because they show me when I have things to do. Each of those stickers, they have a bunch of stickers for different things. So that's my school sticker. So that tells me what I'm doing. And I like filling up my calendar. It feels fun to fill up my calendar. And so I'm looking at trying to figure out to-do lists and how to work it into my calendar. I haven't figured out a way that completely works for me. The cat is climbing into something she shouldn't be, but I don't really care right now. Will you stop, Molly? She's trying to get into the closet. I think she's mad at me because I picked her up earlier. Anyway, I love seeing things in my calendars. I set reminders for things in my calendars. The reminders remind me of things in my calendars. And as someone who's had no social life for 2.5 years, things in my calendar usually mean going and doing things with other people. And I love that. So, I'm going to have to take a very quick bio break, but I will be right back. Okay, I'm back. Sorry for that. I had to rearrange a couple things, fix the way I was sitting, because it was just not comfortable. I'm trying to figure out the best way. My pain makes it very, very uncomfortable to sit at the computer, which is very sad, because I have an amazingly gorgeous pink gaming rig that I built 3 years ago, which is my second baby, and is in the bedroom, and my boyfriend uses it. But I get to use his laptop. So they're basically both ours. I bought the components and he built it for me. But I, you know, I chose the components and he put it together. So it's our baby. We're probably never going to have a child together, so Pinky's our baby. Yes, her name's Pinky. Yeah, I'm back. So, moving onward. So, basically, one of the things that I'm moving towards now is going back to work. And because I have decided I really, really don't want to go back into investments or anything financial, I was thinking originally for school that the accounting and payroll program would be ideal, because the first time I did my paralegal program, I flew through the accounting portion. I just really understood the way the numbers. It wasn't really math, because there wasn't really a lot of math involved. It was more of a matching game. Balance, you know. If this much is over here, it has to be over here somewhere, the same amount, and it's just the balance. And it made sense to me. It was easy. And I found a 38-week course, which is about 9 months. And so I could easily do that and basically transfer my skills that I've used in the last 8 years at a financial lending company. And basically data management, data entry. That's all it is. It was data entry, data manipulation, that kind of thing. And so that's what accounting and payroll does. So I'll transfer it into skills that I could use in any industry. Is what my thinking was going into this program. And 9 months mean I'm going to be back to working pretty quickly. Thankfully, because I'm bilingual, in Canada, there are several agencies I know of who would be able to easily find me a job. That having been said, my first week of class was career management, which was basically resumes and all that stuff. I think I talked about it a little bit on my last video, and that was great because it really opened my eyes and made me think about something. The program, or the school I am in, also has a game design, video game design portion, and I'm a very creative person. I went to art school briefly when I was 18, for a semester. I wasn't ready to go to university, but I was desperate to get away from where I lived and have a new... It wasn't that I was desperate to get away from where I lived. I was desperate for new surroundings, new people, people who didn't know me. I needed to reinvent myself. I didn't reinvent myself. It was bad. Anyway, art school back then was supposed to lead to computer animation, which was supposed to lead to filmmaking, and it didn't. Recently, my boyfriend has, you know, he's a web designer, but he's also a, he has his hands in many pots, let's say. And he basically said that he was going to learn more about game design. And there was this one, oh no, don't do this. Oh, I can't fucking believe Windows right now. Sorry, I'm gonna have to try to bleep that out. So, as everyone knows, Windows 10 is free! Get Windows 10! Free update! Sign up for your free update! Windows 10! Yay! Yes, I signed up for the free upgrade. It's tried upgrading twice, actually three times in the last 2 days, it's failed every time. So now it's just told me that it's gone ahead, but I've heard that it's extremely buggy, and I'm not sure if I'm going to choose to do it or not. So right now is not the time to choose. I'm going to minimize that and deal with it later. That's so funny that showed up now. I'm sorry my dog decided to come join me on the couch. He is noisily licking himself. I don't know why. Anyway. So at school, they have a game design course, two game design courses. One is more of a code programming course. The other is art design and that kind of thing. 2D modeling, 3D modeling, that kind of thing. Which is really funny because one of the courses that I'm going to be doing... Oh, well, I guess... Anyway, I've decided in the last 2 weeks... of doing this course. So I did career management. And in the career management, I was asked to pick two companies I would like to work for and do a research project on them. Just get to know their, you know, where they're located, who the hiring manager is, things you would do if you were job searching and you wanted to get put a resume in at a company. I picked Google and Ubisoft. I picked Google because I heard that a few years ago they opened an office in Toronto, and it's won several awards for best place to work at. I want to work at a place like that. I want to work at a place that gets this is the best place to work at awards. Nothing less. Nothing that has corporate capitalist values over innovation and creativity. So Google was one. Ubisoft was the only, at the time, game studio that I knew had a studio in Toronto, because a friend of mine told me about it. And even game companies, game design companies, need, and now my cats are fighting. Oh, God. It's like Dr. Doolittle in here. They're not fighting. They're just playing. They just play rough sometimes. But they're right behind the laptop on the chaise lounge part of the sectional. And the dog, who is now whimpering because he sees the cats are having fun and he can't play with them because he's a 90-pound Doberman, is making him whimper. Because all he can do is watch, and my cats know this, and Molly especially likes to tease him. It's a zoo in here, I tell ya. I did those two, and I'm like, yes, there was one position that and with some experience, I could probably go to into in the payroll way at Ubisoft, not so much at Google. But I was looking at Ubisoft, and they were listing all their other, and just they really put out there their corporate ideals and things like that, and I want to live in, I want to live, I want to work in a place where I would like to live. I would want to work in a place that makes me feel at home. So, I've went on Monday, or Tuesday actually, because Monday was a holiday. I went on Tuesday to, my education consultant, and I asked him what it would have to happen if I transferred into the gaming course. The game design course. And we talked about it a little bit, and I told him my reasons, basically what I just talked about. And we came up with the idea of I would continue doing, because here's the thing. The business programs have very short modules, 1 week, 2 weeks, that kind of thing. The gaming program has very long modules, 12 weeks. I think there's like 3 or 4 big modules that are 12 weeks each. This means in business, you could start every few weeks. There's a new start available because you can always start at the beginning of a module, how these colleges work. And so I unfortunately just missed the cutoff date for the game design new start, which was July 13th, which was like days after I started thinking about going to school. So the next start is 2 months from now, and October 12th. So that's a disadvantage because I'm currently on the roll and I want to keep moving forward, and I'm kind of being told, no, we have to put on the brakes. Also, the gaming program is 290 weeks long, but officially really only like 74 weeks long because 16 weeks at the end is internship. And that's a big bonus to the gaming program. But it still means, you know, a year and a half before going back instead of 9 months. So about double the time. See, this is what I'm trying to, you know, this is one of the reasons for doing this video, is trying to get my head around the better choice. And I think I hear my lovely boyfriend stirring in the background. I'm probably making a lot of noise. It's almost 10, though. He should be up. But, I'm pretty convinced. So anyway, what me and my education consultant came up with, I stayed in class this week on track for the accounting program. It was the office procedures class. And it's basically how to write, how to work cohesively in a team with other people to get things done in an office setting. Our big project was, anyway, getting meeting minutes, doing kind of want a spreadsheet, doing a bit of research, and doing research. Anyway, yeah, so it went really well. Great professor, like great professor. He comes from the hospitality industry, apparently, originally. A lot of hotel and restaurant and stuff like that. Really cool guy. But even then, it just really solidified, I don't want to go to work in a sterile corporate environment. And if I go into accounting, I might have to settle for that. If I go into gaming, I know I'm going into a more relaxed, you know, situation, a more relaxed program, more relaxed environment. Where things like pink hair and funky hairstyles aren't going to be frowned upon and aren't going to lose me a job. Which, I'm sorry, I did this when I've been on disability because of the reason I have always wanted to do something really funky with my hair and have it for long periods of times. And I couldn't do that working in the corporate way. So I have had this hairstyle for almost 2 years now. It's changed a little bit, but it's finally got, I think it's final, you know, it's my hairstyle now. And I'm not ready to give that up. It's my individuality. It's how I want to be seen by the world. And I don't think where I work should affect that. So, same with my piercings, my tattoos. I'm sure someone would get upset by that one at work. And I do plan on having others. So, I also met a couple of people from the gaming group who were really cool and I felt more comfortable with. So next week I have a reading week or a blank week. It's just blanks in the schedule because of different modules and their availabilities and that kind of thing. So what I've decided, what I've been offered to do is on Monday, I'm going to go sit in on their first class of 3D modeling. I'm just going to observe. And after that, it's in the evening. It's like 6 o'clock at night, which is kind of interesting because I've never done actually something evening wise. I think it could be fun. I could definitely have like a night owl kind of schedule then. But anyway, so I'm going to sit in on class on Monday and I'm going to see what it's like. And I'm about 99% sure that on Tuesday I'm going to write a long email to my education consultant saying, yes, we are going to transfer to game design. I'm stoked. I'm really stoked because of the fact that finally getting to go into something creative, I think, is going to change my life. Because I have a lot of creativity in me, and I've tried to use it even in the freaking office setting. I don't know how many times I participated in certain contests, the Halloween contest. There was a pumpkin carving contest, they didn't like carving because they didn't want the mess, so they had a pumpkin painting and decorating contest. You could poke things into the pumpkin, but no real, like, digging it out and carving it. And I won that several times, or my team helped win it several times. I've painted many things. I've, did a complete, acrylic replication. Oh, it wasn't a replication. It was an homage to the, Van Gogh TARDIS explosion from Doctor Who. Katie, I think I have a few pictures of it. It was for a gift for, a Reddit gift exchange. I didn't even keep it. I actually keep thinking I might do one for myself, but bigger. This one was fairly small. So I'll put a picture of it here. And yeah, I think finally being able to get into the creative field will be the last cog in the wheel, and I can just start moving forward with my new tools to function better. I don't function perfectly, but I'm functioning better, and that's a start. So, 18 minutes, my previous was, I think, 33 minutes or so. So that's just me talking about myself for nearly 50 minutes. Take a break. Come back. You know, I'll tell the others that now it's safe to come back. You know, and come back to hear me talk about my stitchy plans. Hi, and I'm back. I know that was a little longer, and I've changed my shirt. I had to take the dog out, so. Oh, sorry. And then I had to take some time off being on the couch. Because as comfortable it is to stitch, to make these videos, I have to have the... I was talking about this earlier. I kind of went back and reviewed some things, and I think I drifted off on some subjects. So I'm trying to figure out the best way, because I can't really sit at my computer because of my pain problems. And the couch has been mostly okay for stitching. But not really for typing, because I have been using the laptop on the coffee table, but typing that far is not very comfortable. Right now it's sitting on the couch in front of me, so that's not too bad. And I think I have this really cool stand with three-part legs on it that you can make in different configurations for different things. I think I finally found the right configuration for it to use properly on the couch, but I haven't really found the amount of cushion or pillows and back support I'm going to need to be able to do this. Also, my legs, if I'm not completely straight, it can add strain on my back. So, yeah. I think I'm going to try this. Oh, there we go. Oh, see, I didn't want to do this and get up and start moving around. Okay. Yay. That's actually a little bit better. Although I'm a little more scrunched up. If I put both my legs underneath the tray, I feel like I'm lying down more. If I have one leg like this, I can sit up a bit better. So I think I'm going to just do this and go back to under both legs if I'm actually typing. Anyway, so also this way I can lean on here for support as well if my back needs it. Sorry, again, sorry. Did not mean to be there. Oh, that's better. Okay, continuing on. Now, since we've left all that personal stuff back there at minute 54, we can move on to more stitchy stuff. Not a lot, unfortunately, because, again, like I was talking, I didn't get much stitching done. I think I finished on Storytime with Sampler Sherlock's coat in the variegated kind of tweed color that I'm using. That's what I was talking about. Ah, see, now I remember. So I was talking about Sherlock because of the fact that I'm thinking of doing the replica of the wallpaper that I saw someone else do. And I don't have an exact pattern on it. I just have her best picture she could take of it. Which she offered freely. She had no problem with anyone using her idea. So I wanted to move the books. So if I put the books on, I'm going to remove the teapot and make the other ones. I talked about this. Going back to what I talked about. That's the problem with going back and trying to come back to a video, I find. That's why I like doing them all in one stretch. But I'm finding better ways of doing it when I need to break it up, especially long ones. So, we talked about that. The other bit. So, current whip I'm working on. I haven't worked on her very much. I think I worked on her like maybe an hour on Wednesday or so. I'm doing the orange, which is the shadow around her face and the shadow in her hair. I'm thinking of, because the way the pattern is, it's a pixel, it's this little tiny little pixel animated GIF that was turned into a pattern. And because of that, the outlines, there's like several outlines until you reach, where you get the full coverage. Like, I think in the hair, it's going to be yellow, is going to be the majority color, but there's like this orange and another orange before the yellow. And I also think there's white highlights. Anywhere there's white, the wings, in here, these wings here. They have several blues, several variegations of blue until they get to white. I think there's like a medium blue, a lighter blue, a very pale blue, and then white. So it's like confetti, but it's not. It's like a snake. You know, all these different colors until you get to the big one. So, my idea had always been to work by color from darkest to lightest. So I'll always be, you know, working with the darkest color possible at the time. But I think I'm going to change that. Someone's sending me a message. I'll get that to the later. I never get messages. So what I'm gonna do is because her skin tone is only it's this orange and then her skin tone, and I think I have to make her nose shadow in this dark orange color, but I'm almost done the outline of her entire face. And I am hoping to do that, to finish that. I think I have a little bit up here left to do, and finish that, and then start filling it in with the skin color. I think I have some around the. I have to put some of this orange around here as well. But then, like the eyes have different blues and stuff, I have to put in then, and it's like it's confetti, and it is starting to wear on me a bit. The back's really nice though. Does that matter? Does that count? Or something. Oh, I just need a finish, and nothing I have right now, everything's too big to finish easily, and I'm frustrated. So, I'm gonna try to finish the face color, and hopefully that'll make me feel a little bit better about her. And that's what I'm gonna be working on, especially, next week is extremely busy for me. I have so many doctor appointments, and, I'm sitting in on that one class I was talking about, and basically the week after, though, if I do take the plunge and do the gaming course, I'm going to be off until October, but I'm not going to be doing nothing. There's several things I have that I'm going to be wanting to work on daily. One of them is stitching, because I definitely want to, if I'm only going to be going back officially back to school in October, I want to have some of these off my plate, because I need desperately a finish to keep me excited, and I need a new start. I have several new starts possibilities. One is definitely going to be my stitching out Sigma, which is basically the one I'm going to, once I have the, the supplies for, which isn't a lot of supplies, I will be getting those, and, I'll be getting that one started, because I've finalized the design for my stitching out Sigma. I'll go into it, because I think I'm pretty much done with what I want to talk about for Sailor Moon, and I believe it is on my to-do list, so. The stitching out Sigma, I initially had some grand ideas for designs. I wanted to do very representational, very, image-centric representation of what depression and coming out of depression feels like. And I was doing that, I was coming up with various different motifs. I'm, when I do imagery, I tend to be very literal, so, I'm not a very abstract, creative person. So one of them was, a person underneath a rain cloud, the rain cloud that's all gray, dropping gray, raindrops on a gray person, and beyond that grayness is just a world of color. And that was my initial idea, and I just it would have taken a lot longer in the designing phase, because I tried to. I started. I started one day when I was, you know, had nothing else to do. I sat down and I opened PC Stitch, and I just started trying to map it out. I mapped out a, you know, I made a grid, or I brought up a 10 by 10 square on, I think I initially started on 16 count. So I had the right amount of squares, and I just started trying to freehand it. It didn't work. I tried to make some sketches. That didn't really work. I tried different ideas. The furthest I probably got along to was a kind of a mirror image, a girl, bisected, vertically through her, completely. And one side was gray and depressing and horrible, and the other side was just colorful and happy and, you know, all that. It was it needed a lot more time. My creative process can be slow at times until I get the idea. If I get the idea right away, my creative process is very, very quickly. It's very, very quick. If I get the idea and it doesn't work out, trying to move on from that is very difficult. So, I finally said, well, look, I don't have much time. And it's 10 by 10. Sorry. I am sorry. That's my boy. It's okay. We live in an apartment building. I think I mentioned this. It's okay, puppy. Come here. It's okay. You're okay. You're okay. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see him. I don't want you to see the rest of my messy house, because okay. He's settled. He doesn't like coming over on my side of the couch. He has a healthy not boundaries. He has healthy boundaries. And he stays away from my stuff. And I pack up a bunch of my stuff next to me when I'm working on the couch, because I don't have anywhere else to on hand to put it. So I basically, he won't come nearer to me. He stays on his side of the couch. And if I were to turn the video around, you would see my messy entrance area, and I'd rather you not. So, where was I? Stitching out stigma. So, I completely changed gears. I did something, because there's no need to do, you know, a particularly motivational, it didn't have to be admitted. It was anything. You could do anything you wanted to do. So I switched modes. I had this thing I found on Facebook years ago, and it was just a black and white drawing, black background, white silhouette. On top it said, hold on, I'm going to find it so I can read it exactly. Being human is complicated, ... And then there's this beautiful silhouette of a dragon. And on the bottom it says, time to be a dragon. And I've kind of always, I've kind of adopted that as my personal philosophy. For several reasons, some I'm not going to go into, others because it's, you know, when you suffer from mental illness, you're often told everyone else does these normal things. Everyone else is able to pick up after themselves. Everyone else is able to, Sailor Moon decided that she did not like my diatribe. I'll put it over there. You know, it's all about, why can't you be normal? Why can't you function like other people? Human beings have been functioning like this since the beginning of time. Why can't you? You know? It alienates you from your own race, because apparently everyone else except for you on this planet knows how to do everyday things that make your lives easier. And those things don't come easy to me. You react to something in an appropriate way. That doesn't come easy to me. Why can't I just stop being weird and do things the right way, the normal way, the way every other human does it? I don't agree with that. Humans are flawed creatures. Everyone has their own flaws and their own crosses to bear and their own troubles and trials and tribulations. And I think that's human. But I loved this picture. And actually, I'll try to put it here. I'll probably try to put it here. If I can add to it. I've been using the Microsoft My Movie Maker. And it's good in some ways. I love the how easy it is to keep track of if you stop and you come back. That's really good features on it. But it's hard. I can't figure out how to just like insert a floating picture here or that kind of thing. That kind of thing is definitely not. Haven't figured it out yet. I'm still trying to. What else do I have? So that's stitching out sitting mat. So I finally finalized the pattern. And I'm going to put that pattern right here. That's basically the screenshot I took of PC Stitch. And I'm really happy with how it's going to turn out. I'm doing it on Black Ada, which I ordered last night. Strangely, unfortunately, because of the exchange rate with the Canadian dollar is so weak right now, it's insane. Ordering anything from the States basically doubles the amount of money I'm spending. So I've had to find local places to order from. Unfortunately, the big ones like Hirschner's takes forever, and I'm on a time limit. So, Gita's, which is my local needlework store, which you have heard me rave about many, many times, they do ordering off their site. And since they're just, 45 minutes down the road, I'm going to get it sent to me. So I'm getting a fat quarter of black 18-count Ada. I had to go 18-count because I wanted to fit everything in at the ratio I had it. As you saw, the writing's going to be in white. Until the dragon. And the dragon's going to be in gold credit. Because I actually have gold credit. And the dragon was a bit of it was a toss-up. I wanted to do a variegated color in the dragon. And just leave it as a silhouette. And I was trying to find the right one. And I've been wanting to order because of Katie, mainly, the grab bag from Mosel. 23 skeins for $20. It was $18 a couple weeks ago, and I should have grabbed it then, but the price with the shipping is over $50 for me, and that's ridiculous for floss, so I had to restrain myself, but I managed to go through, and I love their colors, and I love the variegation on them. I love the way they come out, and I've seen them being used on many, many things. So I decided to go through and meticulously pick out one color that I think would work. But as you saw, the dragon is fairly big area to stitch, and it's going to be variegated. And that means I'm going to be doing one stitch by one stitch. That might end up getting tedious, especially the way I do it. It may get tedious, it may not, I don't know yet. I am debating maybe cutting out some of the internal fill of it. Maybe like doing the outline or filling it with like swirls or something other than just a solid thing of variegation. I don't know. I'm debating on it. I'm gonna play with it, I think, on PC Stitch a little bit more and see where it's going. But anyway, the color I ended up getting from Moe's sale, I ended up erring on the side of caution. And since the skeins are only a dollar, I got four of them. It's the color's Vision from, I guess, their Avenger line. And it is a bunch of other bright colors, and it's like pink and yellow and blues and green, and like it's a bunch of colors and very pretty. I believe Katie has some, and I've seen it, or someone on Flosstube, I've seen them hold up a skein, and it was absolutely stunning. So I got four skeins of it. With the shipping, it should probably end up costing me about $20. Which is okay. and the piece of cloth is going to end up costing me about $20 as well. Like I said, I could have gotten cheaper from 123 Stitch. I could have gotten the piece of cloth for about $8 with about $8 shipping, so $16. But with, that was American, but with the exchange rate, it was closer to like $30. So it's actually, you know, and I wanted black Aida, and I needed 18 count specifically, so. But yeah, so that's the stitching out stigma. I'm hoping to add in some kind of white back stitching somewhere along maybe the tail. Stitching out stigma or something. It maybe seems kind of goofy, but it's, I think it's going to be a bold picture, especially if it's going to be on a big piece on the wall somewhere. I don't want to, you know. And it's a dragon, and that's my whole signature. It's dragons. So it's me on the wall, you know, helping out and being, bringing awareness. And oh, my boyfriend's mentioned something. Stitching out stigma is like SOS, which I thought was really a cute anagram. I'm sure they thought of that, but I just put it together, or he put it together and told me about it. And so I thought that was cute. So I might end up starting talking about it and saying SOS, my SOS project, just because it's a little quicker than stitching out stigma. So let me check my to-do list. I believe I'm going to do some tags. But this is a long video. You may be the stash queen, but, you may be the stash queen, Katie, but, I think you're going to be hard pressed to beat this video length. I might end up only doing one tag, though. I thought I was going to do, two, but then my rambling about myself went a little bit long. The last thing I want to do is my tag. I have five tags currently on my my Google Docs, and I have five of them. Ooh, I went through Heather Stitches, I think that's her name of her Flosstube. Hi Heather. Made a fantastic master playlist of all the tag videos. So I managed to go and pick up a few tags I haven't done yet. And I found a coffee stitcher tag. I didn't know coffee stitcher did a tag. I had to do it. So I put it on my list. I'm going to do what I did last time because I thought that was fun. And I'm going to randomize with my lovely dice roller on my phone. So I have five tags currently on my list that I haven't done yet. And I'm going to, there's my dice roller. I'm going to roll I keep looking for my mouse, but it's over on the coffee table. And so I keep reaching for it down there, and I look when I don't feel it, and I'm like, where's my mouse? It's over there. So this is the dice roller. It's gotta go. See, a D6. Six-sided dice. So 1 to 5, I'm gonna choose, and if I roll a 6, it'll be my choice. So roll dice. Whee! So it's 4. So I gotta count down. Go back to my dice over here. And 1, 2, 3, 4. The fourth tag is the unnormal tag by Fishy Crafts, or I think it's changed from Fishy Crafts. I think it's something else. Fishy Stitches or something like that. Cindy. I know your name is Cindy, though. Hi, Cindy. I get your tag. Yay. So, the first question. I'm just going to, there we go, move that over here so I can see everything. Perfect. Okay. First question. What is the strangest place you have ever stitched? I would have to say that the strangest place I've ever stitched, in bed. I've tried stitching in bed. It didn't work. I think I lasted about 5 minutes. I haven't really tried traveling with my stitches yet. But I'm planning on, if I ever do travel, bringing stitchy stuff. Sorry. I have an itch. It's not picking. It's an itch. I swear. So I haven't stitched any adventurous places. I'm too afraid of spilling. I'm so bad at, like, keeping my pieces clean in my in my own house, that to travel with them would be silly. 2, what is your next favorite hobby? Gaming. I love all kinds of gaming. I love video gaming. I love tabletop RPG gaming. I love text-based RPG gaming. Board gaming, card gaming. Is it gaming? Yes, please. I love it. I have met so many fantastic people. I have been able to be creative in many ways. LARPing, I even LARP. I used to LARP. Oh, God. Back in the day, I LARPed. That was back in my goth days. I was known as a perky goth. I loved the black and the makeup and the looks, but I didn't really do the attitude. And it's perky off. So yes, gaming of all types. Other than that, anything fan related, geek related, yeah. To smoke or not to smoke? I smoked cigarettes since I was about 17 years old, up until I turned 33 last year. So, 5. I want to say 16 years of smoking. I finally managed to quit with the help of this, which is an e-cigarette. This is a kind of fancy one. They can't see you. When we just went to the kitchen and snuck out, and he was being very cute and stuff. Don't tell him I said that. I'm probably not going to finish. I'm probably going to end up vaping for the rest of my life. I just basically kicked down to zero nicotine, and it has changed my life. The juice and the vapor tastes amazing without the nicotine in it. And yeah, so I'm over a year free of cigarettes, which is fantastic. I just felt like I was burning away money, and I hated that. So, vape. What is your favorite social media to share your stitching on? For the longest time, it was Reddit, because I found the cross stitch. I got back into my stitchy bug because of Reddit last year, and that's where I was sharing it on until I found Flosstube, and now I love sharing it with you guys. And then there's Stitch Mania on Facebook. I love all them. So yeah, all the social media, I guess. I'm also on Instagram, But I don't use that very much. I should probably use that a lot more because I know a lot of you do use Instagram a lot. So, do you model stitch or have you ever? No, but I'd love to give the be given the opportunity to do so. Six, wash or no wash? Everything I've done so far that I've washed has been usually has been on white Aida or other, you know, color fast Aidas with DMC, so I wasn't worried about any bleeding. Things that are going to be heavily, you know, hand-dyed fabrics or hand-dyed flosses, I'm probably going to try to not have to wash them. If you use a digital program, which you use, this could be interpreted a couple ways, because I do use PC Stitch, which is a digital program to create patterns. But on my tablet, I use Zodo, I think is, Zodo, X-O-D-O, which is this one. That's where my patterns are. And I use Dropbox to store my patterns that I have digitally. Either free patterns that I've, actual legitimate free patterns, which I've found, or patterns that I've bought. I like Zodo, but I haven't found a very good, perfect Android app for stitching yet. What do you do with your finished project? Well, I only have, I have two FFOs. I have my Harry Potter Hogwarts crest, which I framed in a dollar store frame myself. I didn't frame it very well. It's a little wrinkly at points, but I don't have the money to reframe it right now, and I really want to get it up on the wall. So it's kind of in there non-permanently, which works. And I'm definitely going to be putting it up very soon, somewhere. Maybe here behind me. I'd really like to put it behind me where I'm stitching. And the other one I've done is the small, Bless This Hive of Scum and Villainy that I did for my boyfriend's birthday. So it is also in a small frame. But it is a very small sampler, so it's okay in that. And it sits on his desk. But I've actually considered with her to do her in a cube. I was originally going to do a pillow, but she's so much work. And I know pillows in my house. If she's not up on a display somewhere, she is just going to literally just not be displayed. So I have considered creating a cube for her. I'd love to find some, Sailor Moon fabric, and that'd be really cool. And I have put her up on my thing, because I think she'd make a really fantastic cube. I do like the idea of, ornaments. I'm thinking about doing an ornament this year with my aught threads, because I think I have enough to make an ornament. It's probably going to be a small dragon pattern. I have several small free dragon patterns from Dragon Dreams off their website, officially free dragon patterns. And they're really kind of complicated, some of them. They have Krennic and, they're teeny little ones. They're very detailed. That's what I do with Frank Bot. So there's my own unnormal tag. Thanks, Cindy, for that. That was really great. My nose is very itchy. I've had allergies, and it's very, kind of overcast today, and my allergies are acting up. So, I don't think I have anything left to say, really. Let me check. Um, No, I don't think so. So I think I'm just gonna say farewell. Oh yes, my future plans for stitching. So if after next week, if I don't do, if I do change courses and don't go back to school until October, I am going to really ramp up the stitching and prioritize my SOS. And it has letters, so it works for the August ABCs. I really can't wait now to start working on it. I believe I have enough white. I have several skeins of white around here, so I'm hoping I should be fine for that. But shit, now I'm thinking maybe I need to order more white. This sucks sometimes. Anyway, I don't like until I go back to school in October, I'm probably not going to kit up anything major except for my SOS. And so I'm just going to keep working on what I can work on my stuff. And hopefully my SOS will be finished by the end of September is my goal on that. And I'm hoping because of the way I designed it with large blocks of color, it's going to go relatively quickly. But now I'm realizing I designed largest block of color for variegated floss. And that might make it a little more difficult, but not impossible. Definitely not impossible. So I definitely want to start a kind of rota at that point, but it's not going to start. I'm not going to have any kind of clear plan of Flosstube videos until then. Like I said earlier with my calendar though, I'm going to start putting Flosstube videos in my calendar to make them and to talk anyway, because I'm losing my stitch bug again and it is unacceptable. And I'm going to claw my way back from getting it, from losing it. So I think I said I wanted to say a shout out to a few of the Flosstubers that I was really liking lately. Brochet, I love your video. I only seen one video, but you seem like an awesome guy. I love seeing more men cross stitching. I think it's fantastic that they're comfortable enough to do so. Because it's a fun hobby and it should not be just, you know. I've had this, there's been a few people who've tried to come on to Reddit and say that they, you know, don't like the profanity cross stitches or the subversive stuff because it goes against the ladylike nature of the craft. And that's just elitist malarkey in my opinion. It include people, because that's how we're going to keep the craft going for many years to come, so that we can all enjoy it. And that's how we're going to have people keep making amazing hand-dyed flosses and fabrics and patterns that make us go, yeah, that looks awesome. You know, that's how we're going to keep the industry alive, by including everyone into the cross-stitch community, not letting anyone out. I'm probably going to be doing another very non-cross-stitch related video here soon, but it is musical related. So if you like musicals, especially if you really liked Sweeney Todd, or if you've ever seen Repo, the Genetic Opera, kind of dark and, you know, twisted musicals, watch it. If you don't, you might want to skip it, because there's not going to be anything stitchy related in it. So if you come across that. Also, oh my god, the biggest news, I forgot to even say anything. I am currently at, and I am amazed by this, 174 subscribers. It's amazing. I'm so thankful that there's so many out there who want to keep watching my videos on a regular basis that you've decided to subscribe. And I think it's great, and I really appreciate it. And when we get to 200, it may take until October before I can afford it, depending on what happens, but there will be a giveaway. Definitely. Or I might just end up giving away something from my stash. But I don't think so, because I kind of want to do everything in my stash. Anyway, I digress completely. I'm so happy with all of you subscribers, and I hope you really enjoyed this video. I know it is super long. This part is 40 minutes. It's going to be over an hour and a half long. I'm sorry, you guys. You've listened to me ramble for an hour and a half. I hope you enjoyed yourself. I hope I didn't, you know, give away too much of my insanity, so that you won't be scared away. Really, I'm quite harmless. Anyway, I hope you guys all have a great weekend. I know I'm going to be, and I will catch up with you guys later. Bye.